for his goodness and his tender mercy and his grace. Nobody like our God. Nobody like our God. And we praise him. And we honor on everything that is of God. Everything that is of God. We want everything that is God. Baba Shede, glory to God. We want everything that is God. A lot of times we've been praying and saying and talking and saying not like God. But we don't want what's like God. We want what is God. Glory to God. Glory to God. We want what is of God. Glory to God. Not what's like. The enemy wants to pretend like he's like. But we want what is God. So we bless you in the name of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We want everything. Glory to God. We want everything that's of God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. In our churches, in our homes, in our city, in our world. Glory to God. We want our world to be like Jesus. Let's go to, this is the second part from last week, but we'll read over the scriptures again from Exodus 20, chapter, starting at the first verse. The part about rehearsing the word of God again. Is God trying to tell you something, part two? Is God trying to tell you something, part two? Let's read Exodus 20, chapter, read along. Starting at the first, and God spake all these words, saying, I am the Lord thy God, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. Thou shalt have no other gods before me. Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image or any likeness of anything that is in heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth. Thou shalt not bow down thyself to them, nor serve them. For I am the Lord thy God, am a jealous God, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children up unto the third and fourth generation of them that hate me, and showing mercy unto thousands of them that love me and keep my commandments. Thou shalt not take the name of the Lord thy God in vain, for the Lord will not hold him guiltless that taketh his name in vain. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days shalt thou labor and do all thy work, but the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord thy God, and in thou shalt not do any work, thou, nor thy son, nor thy daughter, thy manservant, nor thy maidservant, nor thy cattle, nor thy stranger that is within thy gates. For in 6 days the Lord made heaven and earth, the sea, and all that in them is, and rested the seventh day. Wherefore the Lord blessed the Sabbath and hallowed it. Honor thy father and thy mother, that thy days may be long upon the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee. Thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not commit adultery, thou shalt not steal, thou shalt not bear false witness against thy neighbor, thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's house, thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's wife, nor his manservant, nor his maidservant, nor his ox, nor his ass, nor anything that is in thy neighbor's. And all the people saw the thunderings and the lightnings and the noise of the trumpet and the mountain smoking. And when the people saw it, they removed and stood afar off. They said unto Moses, speak thou with us, and we will hear. But let not God speak with us, lest we die. And Moses said unto the people, fear not, for God is come to prove you, and that his fear may be before your faces, that ye sin not. And the people stood afar off, and Moses drew near unto the thick darkness where God was. And the Lord said unto Moses, thou shalt say unto the children of Israel, ye have seen that I have talked with you from heaven. Ye shall not make me with gods of silver, neither shall ye make unto you gods of gold. God trying to tell you something, part two. Is the present tense third person? It's important to question, are we missing? Is it talking to me? is God, the creator, the sustainer of the world, the omnipresent one, the omnipotent one, the omniscient one, the sovereign God, the righteous God, the holy God. Is he trying? Is he straining? Is he severely straining with the power of endurance, trying to tell me, relate something to me, details, give utterance or make known expression in words to me, something. Something that's specified by a thing or a combination of things. And as we established last week, that God doesn't attempt or try to do anything. God gets it done. Just as his word that doesn't return to him void, God accomplishes it. Whatever God wants to do, he does it. It shall happen. If God said it's going to happen, it shall happen. If he willed to happen, it's going to happen because he's God and he's sovereign. Bible lets us know that heaven and earth shall pass away, but my words, the words that I speak, the words that I allow to be written in my holy manuscript shall not pass away. Matthew 24:35. Then the Bible lets us know that whatever God says, he not only has the power to do it, that he cannot lie. The Bible says that God is not a man that he should lie, neither the son of man that he should repent. Had he said it, shall he not do it? Numbers 23:19. Then in Titus 1:2 it says, in the hope of eternal life, which God, that cannot lie, promised before the world began. So we do what? Because God tells the truth that God is talking to us. We seek the Lord as in the book of Isaiah says in 55:6 it says, seek the Lord while he may be found, call upon him while he's near. God speaking to us on scripture says, let the wicked forsake his ways, the unrighteous man, his thoughts, and let him or her return unto the Lord, and he will give mercy upon him and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. The Bible lets us know, for my thoughts and are not your thoughts, God is saying, neither are your ways my ways, saith the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. For as the rain cometh down and the snow from heaven and returneth not thither, but watereth the earth and make it bring forth and bud, that it may bring give seed to the sower and bread to the eater, so shall my word, God said, that goeth forth out of my mouth, it shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper in the thing whereto I sent it. For he shall go out with joy and be led forth with peace. The mountains and the hills shall break forth before you into singing. All the trees of the field shall clap their hands. Glory to God. God is sovereign, and whatever he decides to do, he does it. He's saying, he makes it plain for us to receive it. God is perfect in all his ways. He tells us and he informs us of things in all different kind of manner of ways upon the earth. Because he's God. God speaks through his word in the Holy Bible, in the Holy Book that is inspired by God. God gives us the logos, the written word of God. God sends sometimes a rhema word and he'll drop into your spirit. God speaks to us through prophecy. He'll cause mankind, people to prophesy. And some people are prophets that prophesy and speak to us from the Lord. God speaks through tongues and words of wisdom and knowledge. And God gives us understanding if we ask for it. God speaks to us through interpretations, dreams, and visions like he did with Daniel, Paul, and others in the scripture. Sometimes he speaks to us through that small, still voice like he did with Elijah when he thought he was the only one out there when he was going through. But God let him know, I got 7,000 that haven't bowed to Baal yet. I yet got somebody that's here serving me. God speaks to angels and angelic beings who have been dispatched to earth on various instances throughout the scripture, whether it be they talk to Abraham, Jacob, Daniel, Gideon, Moses, or Joshua, and various others in the scripture. God let them come and talk. Some of us have probably entertained angels in our life unaware. And God speaks through signs and wonders. God speaks through people. He speaks through nature. He speaks through creation. And God will speak through an animal if he has to. Circumstances. And he'll speak. And the list goes on and on. And God never lets us down. God never fails, and God gives instruction. He gives direction. He gives guidance. He puts people in your path to lead and guide you in the way you should go. God gives encouragement. God challenges us. God will rebuke us and correct us and discipline us. And God gives us the victory. But we must follow the plans and the purpose and the destiny and the blessings and promises God has prepared for us. So we as a people of God and the people, we must discern and recognize the voice of God through the word of God, through reading the word and studying the word and meditating and letting the word marinate in our minds, in our heart, and in our soul. God makes our ways prosperous and gives us great success when we adhere to what he teaches and tells us, when we have faith to trust in God, when we know the truth, and the truth makes us free, and we know the facts from God, and most of all, knowing his word. And then when we know God's word and God speaks to us, we must move by faith according to his word, understanding that God will never contradict himself. He will never contradict his word. He will never come short of his word and what he said. Whatever he's speaking to us, and many times do many things in our lives, God can use whatever he wants. And remember, it's not the way that we feel, but it's doing the will of God. It's not in what you think and what you feel, but it's in doing what God says, what he has told you to do. Every word, every command, everything, whether it's get your house in order, get your life in order, get on the straight and narrow path, God is speaking to us. We must submit to the voice and command of God, giving God a yes. A lot of people don't want to give him a yes, but you got to give God a yes. It's an act of obedience to God according to his word and command with swift obedience. For obedience makes us special to the Lord. Let's move when he says go. When God says go, run as fast as you can. When God says stand still and be quiet. Yeah, when God says stand still and see the salvation of the Lord, that's what you do. When God says pursue, you pursue. When you ask him, when you talk to him, when he talks to you, when God says listen, you listen more than you've ever listened before. When God says hear what the Spirit is saying to the church, write it. When God says write it down, when he says write, whatever God says to do, you ought to be running, doing what God has told you to do, saying only what God says, and doing only what he said to do, having peace with mankind, answering the call that God has put on all of our lives, running your own race that God has set before you, and staying out of everybody else's lane and races in business in your life, walking in the Spirit, humbling yourself at the feet of Jesus, honoring and loving God, respecting God, having reverence with God, and then setting your mind, setting your affections on things above, the things of heaven, and not compromising God's word and lifestyle that he's called us to live in this day and time. But many times, what do we do as people of God and as citizens of this world? Many times, we tune out the voice of God. We do like little children try to do their parents sometimes. They try to hum them out, try to tune them out. We don't want to listen to what God says, but we think we know better than what God knows. We don't want to listen. We want to procrastinate when he tells us to go, tells us to do when he calls us. Sometimes we're hard-hearted. Sometimes we reject even what God is saying. And many times we'll even rebel against the word of God. And then sometimes we forsake God. Sometimes we're stubborn. As little children, we're stubborn. We don't want to do it. We're stiff-necked. Sometimes we delay. Sometimes we don't adhere. We don't follow the commands of God and adhere to what he said. And many times we're fatally distracted by our own will, by our own feelings, by our own selfishness, our own personal goals and objectives and hidden agendas that we got. But God's got some promises and plans for us. He's got some blessings for us if we do it the way God has commanded us to do it. But the Bible lets us know what we should do is first seek ye the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Then the Bible lets us know that all these things, everything you're looking for in your life, God will add it unto you. But if we learn anything, as we continue, we're trying to come out of this pandemic, and God has given the scientists and doctors some knowledge to come up with some vaccination that we pray will work. If we learn anything, we ought to listen to the voice of God. We ought to hearken to God's every command. And we ought to get an understanding of what God wants us to do. Don't go off half-cocked and half with the half story, but get everything that God wants you to do. And then we got to move by faith in the direction of God, doing a 180-degree turn, turning from our wicked ways and heading in God's direction, the pathway that's going to lead us to righteousness and lead us to heaven. And who can, as Paul in the scriptures, who can kick against the pricks? Some people are kicking against the gospel and kicking against what God would have them to do. But you want to get on pathway with what God would have you to do. Who can stand against the true and the living God? We don't want to be turned over. Oh, you don't want to obey. You don't want to be turned over into the hands of the living God. But many times the knowledge is there and the command is there. There's a woe, there's a warning is there. But we've rejected what God has said. We reject it just like the children of Israel. Sometimes we reject what God says and has given to us as the principles to live today. Hosea 4 and 6 said, my people are destroyed for the lack of knowledge because thou hast rejected knowledge. I will also reject thee, that thou shalt be no priest to me, seeing thou hast forgotten the law of thy God. I also forget thy children. Rejecting the plan of God is readily available in his word. God has a hope and a future and an expected end for all of us. And God wants us to live according to his word. God is expecting a return on his investment that he has invested in us. God has called us to love him and to serve him only, to be holy. What has God asked you to do? He says, be holy. Why? Because I am a holy God. He says, sanctify yourself. Come out from among them. Come out from that evil. Come out from that sin and shame and live in the light. Live what's right. Take off the work of darkness. Change your diet. Change your appetite. And constantly work on your own salvation with fear and trembling. Sanctified people of God, we got to flee from sin and evil. We got to learn the difference between good and evil. And we got to do what's right. We can't compromise. We can't give in. But we got to do it the way God says do it. We got to observe and govern ourselves according to the divine laws and commands of God. We got to learn to live holy. The song years ago said, I've learned to live holy. I've learned to live right. We got to continue to learn and do it unto death or until Jesus come back. The Lord ought to be in your mind. He ought to be in your heart. He ought to be in your soul. And then if you hide the word, if you read this word, study the word, you hide the word. Like David said, thy word am I hid in my heart that I might not sin against thee. The only reason you need to live holy is because God said live holy. The only reason you need to know and be separated from sin because God said be separated from sin. And if you read your Bible, God lets us reveal the word to us what's going to happen at the end. So there's a reason why you need to live holy. Sometimes our parents told us, they just told us some things. They said, because I said so. There's some things we do because God said so. Because he's God. We may not understand it. We can't figure it out. We can't put our finger on it. But we do it because God said do it. We got to understand that God will not accept us if we don't live holy. Holy in lifestyle. Holy, in other words, the Bible said conversation, which is your lifestyle, your actions, your thoughts, your deeds. God reigned over the heathen. God sitting upon the throne of his holiness. And then the Bible tells us that if we live for God, God has spoken to us. He says, follow peace with all men, holiness without which no man shall see the Lord, in Hebrews 12 and 14. We got to understand we can do it through God, Jesus, and the Holy Ghost. We can do it through the Trinity. We can live this thing. It's not hard to live right if you make up your mind that you want to go with Jesus. If you make up your mind you want to do this thing, you can do it. Because you are your own biggest enemy. You got to make sure that you want to do this thing. So in Exodus chapter 20, we see God speak And when God speaks, everything has to listen. For God is the greatest. God is the best. God is the creator of everything. He's the creator. And we understand that the creator is greater than the creation. And God gives the law. He gives the commandments in the word of God. For where there is no law, there's lawlessness, there's confusion, there's no order, there's no rules. There's no way to govern. I don't want to live in a place that's lawless, that has no laws, that people can drive any kind of way they want on the road. We all will be killed if people drive in a school zone at 100 miles an hour. But we got to have laws, and God gives out the commands in Exodus. But our God is a God of order, and just as he has from the beginning, he spoke and continues to speak. Yes, there was a time in Scripture when God went silent. And we don't want God to be silent. We want God to speak. We want to be able to get in touch with God. But when he speaks, we know what God is saying. And we ought to want to know what he's saying. He will place someone in your life even to give you instruction and leadership and to lead you to him and to point you to God. He'll give pastors after his own heart to you. And God gives the word and lets them know who he is when he gives them the word in Exodus. The God that created them, the God that led them out, the God that brought them out, and the God that continued to provide for them and make ways out of no way for them. So when God speaks with the commandments, he has never spoken like this ever before. When we read in Scripture, we've never seen God speak like he did when he put the commandments out. He never spoke like he had back then. He's speaking to mankind today, but he really spoke when he put the commandments out. His awesome power, his providential law when he put it out. And we ought to take heed to what God is saying. He is the only true and living God, and he is the only supposed to be worshipped. So if we're going to get our life together, if God is speaking to us, we're going to turn our life around. People of God, people in the world, you need to worship the true and the living God. As he states in the Holy Commandments, God gave the law before it was written. In mankind's hearts and mind, God gives the law. And God's eternal. He's everlasting. He's self-existent. And God makes a covenant. And he keeps his covenant. And he's obligated to keep his word and command, which he can swear by himself because he's God all by himself. The promises of God, the deliverances, and the freedoms that we have in him. So God's love and charity for us, as God has placed the commandments before the children of Israel in the book of Exodus, the first and foremost command is what always is in danger in society. Is breaking in society. It's always in danger by not having any other God before me. Glory to God. God doesn't want you to have anybody before him. If there's anything in your life more important than God, it's a God in your life. And you need to remove it out of your life. God is your rock. God is your helper. God is your number one priority. And we serve a jealous God. Glory to God. And we're praying for mercy and grace every day. We're praying. We're interceding for mankind. We're crying out that God will hear our prayer and hear our call, that God will turn things around in our society and in our world and in our families. If we're going to get a change, we need God to change it. We need God to turn it around. And the only way we can turn it around is through seeking God and applying the word and what God has put in his word from day one, from the beginning, when he established the nation, is to keep him first. We got to understand that God wants all the praise. He wants all the honor. He wants all the glory. And he deserves our praise. So let us remember God and keep his commandments. When mankind couldn't keep the commandments, what did God do? God sent his son wrapped in human flesh for us. 100% human, 100% God and divine. Jesus came. He didn't come to destroy the commandments, but he came to be the fulfillment of the law and the prophets. Jesus made peace with God so that we can get the peace of God. And the Bible lets us know, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to what? To condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. What is God telling you to do? What is God saying to you? Whatever he's saying, he's speaking in your language. Oh, you don't have to worry about interpreting. God is speaking your language. What is he telling you to do? What is God telling you? Is he telling you to obey? Will you trust God with your money, with your time, with your life? Will you trust God? Will you follow him all the way? Will you say yes to God? Will you change your attitude, your mind, and your condition? Will you amend your ways and your doings? Will you believe the report of the Lord? Will you study the word of God? Will you read the word and apply it to your life? Everybody ought to read at least a scripture every day. Everybody ought to pray every day, at least three times a day. Will you receive and live with the Holy Ghost in your life? So will we keep God first. What is God saying to you? Is God trying to tell you something? He's not trying to tell you, but he's making it plain. You got to listen to the voice of God. You got to listen to the good thing that God has put in your life. Will you live for God? Will you forgive others? Will you persevere through this life to inherit eternal life? Will you endure the pain and suffering of this present time to establish and receive the gifts of God? Are you willing to run this race? Because quitters never win, and winners never quit. If you want to go with Jesus, you can't quit on God. You can't quit on a pure religion. You can't quit on your salvation. You gotta keep on running. Sometimes it gets hard. Sometimes the day gets dark. But I'm gonna keep on trucking on in my lane. God said, drive through the storm and rain. Keep on driving to the other side. Don't you stop in the midst of your storm. For God said, he's speaking to mankind. Will you worship me in spirit and in truth? Take them idols out your life. Somebody got some things that are more important to you than your God. And you better remove those things and get God in your life. God's number one. He's not going to play second fiddle. Will you praise me at all times? There's two times to praise him. When you feel like it and when you don't. God said, will you bless me at all times? Will you trust me with your life? Give God your life. Will you pray till something happens? Will you pray day and night? Will you pray for your family? Will you pray for your friends? Will you pray for your enemies? Pray to God. God says, will you obey my word? Will you keep my command? Will you study it? Will you apply this word to your life? God's speaking to us. Will you walk with me? Will you talk with me? And will you tell me that I am your only God? Will you look unto God and trust in God? You, but sometimes during the day, I just thank God for everything you've given to me. You bless me, the young man. I'm blessed to be a blessing. God said, walk in the authority that you have in Christ Jesus. Are you going to be my child? You're my child, and if you belong to God, greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. You can have the armies against you. You can have everybody against you. But if you got Jesus, if you got God on the inside, he's more than the world against you. God is speaking to us. Will you diligently seek me? For I'm a rewarder of them that seek me. And my reward is greater than your pay. I will reward you if you call on me. Don't wait till the battle is over. Don't wait There were storm clouds covering your life. Don't wait till death is in your family. Don't wait till you're in the hospital, laying on your back. But call on me each and every day and believe on me as the scriptures say. And out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. Will you follow him who is the way, the truth, and the life? God is saying, follow Jesus. This is my beloved son in whom I will please. Are you going to follow Jesus? Are you going to bow down to Jesus? Everything going to bow down to Jesus. In the earth, under the earth, above the earth, because he's got all power. He's got power over death, hell, and the grave. He's got power. He's got the keys. God gave him the keys. And if you want the keys to life, if you want keys to eternity, God said you got to commit your body, commit your soul, commit your mind unto me. God says, serve me only. Is God speaking to you? Now he wants something from you. He wants your life. He wants 100% of you. God says you can't serve two masters. You can't serve God and the devil. You can't serve God and mammon. I'm a jealous God. I'm not taking 10%. I'm not taking 12%. I'm not taking 40%. I'm not taking 75%. And 99.5% just won't do. God says, I want 100% of all of you. Are you going to serve me? Are you going to receive from me? God says, I have the Holy Ghost readily available. Are you willing to receive the power of the Holy Ghost? Are you willing to walk on the anointing of the Holy Ghost? Is God telling you something? Is God telling you to clean your house? Is God telling you to get rid of some bad relationships? Is God telling you to quit your bad habits? God's a habit breaker. He can break your bad habits. He can turn things around. He can turn your tongue around. He can turn your bad talk around. He can turn your gospel around. He said, give it to me. If God's speaking to you in the name of Jesus, do it while the blood is running warm in your vein. If you want to go to heaven, if somebody said, I wouldn't mind dying if dying was all, but there's a judgment day. There's a judgment day coming, and I'm on my way. And you all want to be on your way to heaven. Don't you believe the devil. Don't you believe these false prophets. Don't you believe these false religions. There's a judgment day coming, and you got to answer for everything you've done in this mortal body. You better confess. You better repent to God. If God talking to you, he's talking through the scriptures. He's walking through. The Spirit of God is touching right now. He's healing right now. He's saving right now. He's delivering right now. I cast the devil out of your home. I cast that dark cloud out of your home so that you can receive the light of Jesus. Get your blessing. Get your blessing. Get your miracle. God says, I got a miracle for you. And God's saying something for you. Somebody's son is on their deathbed, but God's got a miracle for you. Is God speaking to you? Somebody believe it's all over. But God says, live and not die. God says, got you in my hand, and there's nothing that the devil can do unless I allow him to do it. I got all power in my hand. I'm God all by myself, and beside me there is no other. If somebody's feeling like they're all alone, but if you call on Jesus in your God. If you give your house to the Lord, give your church to the Lord, turn this church around. Turn the kingdom of God. Oh, God, turn that workplace around. Somebody's working somewhere, and you let the enemy run rampant. But take authority in the name of Jesus and say, God, I lift my workplace up to you. Touch it in the name of Jesus. Touch it that I can work in peace. Turn this world upside down for Jesus Christ. Let's get radical for Jesus. Let's do everything the word of God says. I'm blessed because I live in obedience. I follow Jesus. Jesus will help us all the way through. Through the power of the Holy Ghost. You can't do it in your power. You got to do it in the power of God. So Lord, we hear you. We're listening to what the word says. We're listening to what the preacher says. We're preached to us. We're receiving from you. And God, we're listening. Help us, Lord. Our world needs to be healed. Our world needs to be delivered. We need, oh God, you and our families, our sons and daughters need you. Our grandchildren need you. Our great-grandchildren need you. Our friends need you. Our enemies need to be saved. So, Lord, help us. We're listening, Lord. We'll listen to those who you have given to us. We'll listen to those who have rule over us. The children of Israel said, Moses will listen to you. Don't let God speak like that again. We'll listen to what you're saying when you receive from God. Somebody need to listen to the pastors and the preachers and the teachers. And God has put in your life. He's ministering to you. He's speaking to you through them. And hear what they have to say. And be blessed. And live for the Lord. What is the Spirit saying to the church? What's in your spirit? He has already told you what to do. So let us follow the roadmap to heaven. I'm on my way. In the promised land, I gotta stay in the word day and night, meditating on the word of God, that God will have full course in my life. Be in tune with what the Spirit is saying. You gotta fast and pray. You gotta worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness that you can hear from the Lord. When you pray to God, make sure it's a two-way conversation. That you pray and that you listen to what God is saying. God will lead you and guide you. He will direct you in the path you need to go. God is doing it for us. What is God saying? Glory to God. God trying to tell you something. No, he already told you. He's telling you. He's speaking to you. He's speaking to you. Glory to God. He's speaking to you. You know it's God. And a gentleman yesterday, he had an issue, and he ran into me, and then I told him some things. He said, well, God must have led me this way. Glory to God. God will lead and guide you in the direction you need to go. If you follow the plan, follow his manuscript, follow the word of God. Obeying those that have rule over you. Obeying and following leadership. God knows what's best for us. He knows us. He's put leaders to point you back to God and to hold you accountable. Many people won't be accountable. But God knows just what we need. Let's be accountable. Let's be faithful unto God, unto death. We can't quit, almost there. We got to go all the way.
retire. I'd like to retire from work. I served the Lord 33 years and 7 months. But you got to stay saved and stay with the Lord all the way until He called you home, or until Jesus come back. You cannot quit. You cannot throw in the towel. You cannot let people make you quit doing what God's told you to do. God is in control. People let people make them quit their job and they stay on their job. Make you quit your job and lose your money and they stay there and they still there. You ought to quit. Or they do everything they can to antagonize you, but they're there, making their paycheck and you're suffering. Make sure we'll be led and guided by the Spirit of God. God trying to tell you something. We ought to pray until we get a breakthrough. Pray till we hear from God. Pray. If you need healing, you pray till God says, I'm going to heal you, but my grace is sufficient. Pray till you get an answer. A lot of times we don't pray long enough. We don't pray our way through. God heard you the first time you prayed, but are you consistent? Are you determined? Neelys, I heard you. Your prayer went up for a memorial from day one. Daniel, I heard you when you prayed your prayers the first day. But there was a war in the heavens, in the air. Blessings delayed are not denied. God's got a blessing for all of us. We cannot quit. We cannot throw in the towel. In other words, we got to get up on the horse and ride. 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 Stay in the race that is set before you. Many times people come and say, they want you to tell them what they already know. You got all the signs of telling you what you should do, but you want to hear somebody else say it. So you can say they told you, but you already knew it's already. What knew what you're supposed to do. Let's do what God has called us to do. So the Lord can say, well done, my good and faithful servant. You've been faithful. Because we can't point the finger on judgment day. They made me quit. God is not going to hear that. They made me leave. God said, what did I tell you to do? What did I say to you? Didn't I say I'll be with you? Then Jesus said, I'll be with you to the uttermost end of the world. Let us finish our course. God's already told you. God's speaking to many of you right now. You know what God told you to do. And all the list of what I said in this message, you've done it. You procrastinated, you didn't listen, you tried to avoid it, we went another way. Some people do as much like Jonah. We're going to dive on a ship or on a plane going in the opposite direction. But we may not get another opportunity like Jonah did. Some people died running away from God and never got a chance to get back to Him. Never got a chance to finish the assignment or what they were supposed to do. But let us do everything God has told us to do in this day and this hour. This is a life thing that we're going through in the world. Glory to God. God is bringing us out this pandemic. Glory to God. Let us do what God has called us to do. He's bringing us out. Let us continue to see intercede for each other. New presiding bishop on yesterday when he was installed said, I'm calling for a 10-week prayer on Tuesdays and Wednesdays for an hour. So saints of God, people everywhere, Tuesdays and Wednesdays dedicated to prayer time. He's got different offices that are going to pray every week. But he wants the church to seek the Lord. We need to seek the Lord. need to call on him. We need to call on the Lord. These come by fasting and praying. We want to change in our family, change in our world, change in our life. We ought to fast and pray. Seek the Lord while he may be found. And then let us obey God's will and command. Let us obey what God has told you to do. If God has told you to do something you haven't done, repent today. Say, God, I'm sorry I didn't go when you told me to go. Some people lost their assignment because they didn't go when it was time. You lost your blessing. Somebody else got it. You got to ask 17 times if you didn't go. Now it's passed you by. But you can still have salvation. You can still receive forgiveness. So if you're a sinner today, or if you've been disobedient, ask God to forgive you today. Lord Jesus, forgive me. Forgive me of the wrong I've done, the wrong I've been. Forgive me of my disobedience. Forgive me, oh God. Forgive me of my sins. I believe that God raised you from the dead. My Lord Jesus, come into my life. Come into my heart. Cleanse me of all my sins, all unrighteousness. Come into my heart. Be Lord and Savior of my life, and I will serve you for the rest of my life. Make that commitment. And even if you fall off track, Jesus is faithful and just to forgive you of all your sins. You make a mistake. Get back on track. Don't let the sun go down on that day. Repent right then. When you make an error, you make a mistake, you sin, repent right then. Sometimes only you know, you the only one know you did. You know you did it. Right then, Lord, I forgive me for what I just done. Forgive me for what I just said, God. And you back in the kingdom of God. Ooh, glory to God. Don't let the devil win. Maybe you need to receive the Holy Ghost. If you're saved, you've repented of your sins. And Jesus said, I'm praying to the Lord. I'm praying to my Father, another comforter for you. I'm going back to glory. I've done my assignment. But I'm praying another comforter for you. And he's going to send it in my name. So God, we pray. Send the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. Send the Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, send it. Fill and refill with the Holy Ghost. Fill our cup, let it overflow. Send the anointing. Send the power of the Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus. Pray that prayer that you receive the Holy Ghost. Maybe you're sick in your body. Read the scriptures. Read the word of God. The Bible says that God healeth all our diseases. By Jesus' stripes we were and we are healed. So read the word of God. If you don't believe it, read it until it gets in your heart and your mind. And then when you pray for others, don't forget sometimes to pray for yourself. Sometimes you just need a point of contact. So since we've been in this pandemic, many can't come to the physical churches like they used to. But when I say this as a point of contact, put your hand on what is ailing you. You can put your hand on. As a point of contact, we can speak it, but put your physical hand there and say, Lord, heal my body in the name of Jesus. Heal my digestive system. Heal me, oh God. Dry up this cancer. That's your name, glory. It's in my colon. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Grow the bone back. And they said, we'll grow no more. God, grow the bone back. Glory to God. In the name of Jesus. Fix that esophagus. In the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Touch that eardrum. Touch them knees. Woo! Glory to God. Touch them legs. In the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Touch my feet, God. Glory to touch them toes. Touch them fingertips in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Somebody can feel today. Touch them fingertips. Glory to God.
Touch God.
Touch that sinus condition.
Glory to God.
Glory to God.
Touch that asthma.
Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Touch that back.
Touch that spine. Glory to God.
In the name of Jesus, touch it, God. And believe God. God is a healer. God can heal you immediately, suddenly. He can heal you next week. He can heal you. Just believe that God is a healer.
Glory to God.
Will you trust me? Will you believe me? I can heal your body.
Glory to God.
And then follow what God tells you to do.
Glory to God.
Follow the plan. Sometimes we got to go through the doctor's plan to get healed. But follow the plan.
Glory to God.
Follow the plan. Whether God heals you immediately, suddenly, or through medicine, follow the plan.
And live until God says it's all over.
Is God telling you something?
God trying to tell you something?
No, he already told you. He's telling you every day, every hour. He's telling you. All you see the signs every day. He's telling you right there. He's speaking. He speaks to everything he wants to speak to.
Glory to God.
Thank you, Lord. We thank you now, God, for this word. Thank you for these that have repented of their sins. Those that, God, have not been listening and not being adhering to your word. We pray, God, that you would touch them, that they would adhere and follow you and be obedient so they can be blessed. God blesses us when we obey. There's a blessing in obedience. And we thank you for the blessing. Thank you that we hear you, that we hear. And thank you, God, for hearing us. Because the Bible said, when we turn from our wicked ways, we pray to you. He said, now my ears are open. I'm attentive. I'm listening to their prayers, that they're praying. So let us turn from our wicked ways. Let us humble ourselves and pray that God will hear our prayer and God will heal our land, that he will heal us, that he will take care of our children. Some of us got children overseas. Some of you got children thousands, thousands of miles away. You can't stay up all night, can't stay up all day, but God, I put them in your hands. Glory to God. Watch over them, keep them, shield them, save them, give them mind to be saved, to turn it around before it's too late.
Glory to God.
Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
And even when they go in the ditch, they'll come out without a scratch on them. Glory to God. Thank you.
Thank you for the anointing of the Holy Ghost.
Thank you for keeping our children. Keep this generation of God. And they will come in and serve you like never before. We call them the north, south, east, and the west. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank God. Amen and amen. Praise God for Jesus.